Hello everyone, good morning. Today I am going to discuss the crystallographic directions. So let's see. In this question we have taken a few numbers of crystallographic directions and we will show how to draw that directions. So this is our crystal structure, that is the cubic unit cell. Okay, where these are the x, y and z directions in it. We know that the directions are given in form of this, that is a u, v, w, that is in the first case, that is 1, 0, 0. So 1, 0, 0, 1, 0 and 0 are representing the projection length of on x, y and z axis. So in this particular case, the projection length on x axis is 1. And that on y and z axis are 0 and 0 respectively. Okay, so let's draw the first direction, that is 1 0 0. So let's see, this is our origin in the first case, and first we have to go to 1 unit in x direction, so we will reach here. Then no any propagation should be in y and z because there is no intercept here, so only this directions. So you can see this directions, this direction. Okay, let me change the color. So this direction basically will be the 1 0 0 direction. Now let's see the next direction, that is 1 1 0. So in this case also you have to first move to 1 unit in x direction, then 1 unit in y direction, so you will reach here. Okay, you will reach at this position. And there is no any movement or no projection length in along the z direction. So this will be our final position. Now you have to just meet them. So that will be. So you can see this will be the. So that direction, basically this direction is 1 0 0, and this direction is what? 1 1 0. Okay, now let's see the next one, the C, that is 0 1 0. So now we don't have to move along the x axis because that is 0 projection. Now y axis, this is 1, so we will reach at this position 1, and z axis again 0. So now just we have to join these two lines, and if we join, okay, so this basically will be the, this will be our 0 1 0 directions. Okay, next the D1 is 0 1 1. So again we don't have to move along the x direction. So first we move along the y axis, so this is the first 1 unit, then along the z direction, so this is the first 1 unit and this is our final position. Again we have to meet this origin to this point, so again what we have to do, just meet it. Okay, so let's match it. Okay, so this direction will be our the D1, that is the 0 1 1. That will be the Zero, one, one. Okay. Now let's see, E is 001, so in that case we don't have to move along x and y axis, only we have to move along the z axis. So this is the one unit. Now we have to meet these two points, so join them. Okay, just join it. Let's take this one, simply join them. So this will be the direction, basically will be, yeah. So this will be the 001. Now next F is 101. So first you have to go to one axis like the 1, then along the y axis is 0, then you have to again move with one unit at z axis, so you will reach this position. So you have to meet these two points, so just meet it, join them. So just join them, sorry, join with different color. Okay, make it somewhat colorful. Okay, so this direction, so this direction will be what, the F, that is the this direction will be 101. So 101. Next is 1, 1, and 1. So let's see that you have to go to first one distance along x axis, so you will reach there. After that you have to go to along y axis at one unit, so you will reach here. Then again with the z axis, so you will reach at this position. So yes, you have to join these two lines. So yes, you can join them easily. Join it. Yeah. So this will be yes. So that will be our, the next one is what? 1, 1, 1. So that is the 1, 1, 1 direction. Okay. Next what we have? 1, 1, 1 bar. 1 bar is negative. So in z axis it is negative, so you have to be careful in choosing the particular origin for this. If you choose this as the origin, you don't have z as negative. Okay, you have only z positive, negative will be downward, so this will not be visible. Okay, so let's see that. If you choose this one, so yes, z will be negative in downward direction, so this is the perfect origin for this. Now first you have to go to one distance along x axis, so this is x axis, so 1. Then you have to go along y axis, so again you will go to this place 1. So 1, 1, and 1 bar. Then you have to go along the z axis, so that is the 1 bar. So basically this was our origin and this was our last position. You meet them together, use some different color. Okay, use that, and just you have to meet them. Okay, join them, and this will be the what, your direction. Yeah, so that is the direction, that is 1, 1, 1 bar. 1, 1, 1 bar. Okay, next is 1 bar 1 and 1 bar. So you have to choose a particular, you know, you have to choose a particular crystallographic that the origin in which there should be possible for the negative for the x-axis as well as z-axis. So if you choose this position, it is not possible. If you choose this position, so it will be negative for x axis, yes, negative for y axis, but and negative of negative for y axis, yes, and negative for z axis, yes. Okay, so but y should be in positive in this case, so you can't choose that one. If you choose this one, negative for x axis is possible, yes. So negative for y axis and no possible, but we don't know negative for y and negative for z possible. So again, this will be the origin. First we have to go to, no, negative for x axis is not possible, sorry, for this one negative for x axis is possible. Okay, y axis we don't know negative. Okay, and z axis, yes, negative is possible, so go for that. So this will be our origin in this case. So let's see, this is our origin. This is our origin in this case. We have to go minus 1. So opposite of x, that is, we will reach here. Then 1, so we will reach along y axis at this point. And then negative of 1, so you will reach this one. So our origin was this one. This was our origin. And the final was this one. You just join them. Okay, so let's join them. It will be this one. So yes, this line, basically this will be 1 bar, 1 1 bar. So that's all about this lecture. I hope you understand. Thank you very much.